All kids out of the pool.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Save one for me, please.
They're beautiful.
This even smells definitive.
Did you guys read this introduction?
With the children of baby boomers now applying, competition for college admission has never been stiffer. Where 1500 on the SAT was once considered golden, it is no longer enough for those with Ivy League aspirations unless...
They want better than 1500?
Unless accompanied by an impressive, well-rounded resume, including extracurriculars.
You mean like sports and stuff?
But I was sure my 1460 would get me into Yale. Now what are we going to do?
It says here we could get into Palomino Teachers College or Praise the Lord University.
Great. While you're at it, why not just enroll us at Borchmore?
Hey, what's going on? I heard Borchmore.
Did someone say Borchmore? Go cavemen.
We got fire, we got wheel, we got caveman sex appeal. Go Borchmore! Ooga chaka, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka.
Come on, guys, join in. Don't you want to follow in your brother's footsteps?
Yeah, like I'm going to Borchmore.
Hey, we were Playboy's number 6 party school, and we had more fraternity drinking deaths than all of your Ivy League schools put together.
And that doesn't include hazing deaths.
Too bad we don't have the code.
What code?
Oh, it's just a rumor I heard in computer camp about a repeating pattern in the SAT answers. If you could crack the code, bingo, 800s.
Well, in the absence of such a code, unless we all want to be cavemen, I suggest it's time to improve our resumes. And what do our resumes need?
Extracurriculars.
Mr. Solansky, what extracurriculars do you recommend for the student with Ivy League ambitions?
Oh, don't ask me, kid. Lucky for me, we had NAM. I didn't have to go to college.
Maybe this one wouldn't be so bad.
Volleyball?
I played on the beach once.
Sure! And this list is practically all girls. How bad could it be?
Mine!
Get that back!
Maybe it was badminton we played on the beach.
So is my massage class paying off? Do you think I'm ready to go professional?
Oh, yeah. I minored in massage at Borchmore.
Ooh, can I go next?
Sure.
Oh, yeah. Last time I felt an ass like this, Eisenhower was president.
Ah, holy crap!
Oh, he's joshing you, Andy. He says the same thing about my ass.
I'll take Soledad.
I got Mabry. I don't want any more. You can have the homos.
Get in the back. You look smart. Hold my cigarette. And don't bend it or I'll kill you.
I got it.
And I just don't think this is what the Ivy League had in mind.
Look out, Kevin.
Duck!
Hey, watch out for my cigarette.
It's doing fine, miss.
Kevin?
Oh, double 800s.
Huh?
If we could get perfect scores, we wouldn't need this humiliation.
Sure, but how?
Toby, you said there may be a code out there, a way to crack the SATs. It's our only hope, and by God, I'm going to find it. As soon as I find the exit.
All right, look, yo.
Your style is generic. Mine's authentic made. I roll like a renegade.
To listen to the individual, the metaphysical
voices, the fiery chain. 313
area bound to barrier within.
Who want what? Who pumped up to get rolled
up? So here I go, it's my shot. Feet famine, and this may be the only opportunity that I got. You better put this down in the music. The moment you hold it, you better never let it go.
Something's gonna happen. It needs to happen now.
Rated R at theaters Friday.
This time, there's nowhere he can't go. In Spider-Man 2, The Game, you have the freedom to go wherever you want, whenever you want. Use amazing new abilities to hop from blacktop to rooftop and save the city one crime at a time. Spider-Man 2, The Game. Rated T for teen.
Look, all the SAT tests are generated by the same computer, right? And no computer is completely random. So, if we get enough tests and run the answers through our own computer, we should be able to find a pattern.
That sounds like cheating.
But is it? Perhaps you'll recall the Kobayashi Maru, the most difficult test at Starfleet Academy. It crushed every cadet who took it, except for one. A sassy young lad who defeated the test by simply reprogramming the computer. Maybe you've heard of him? Captain James Tiberius Kirk?
That is so not true.
It is true. It happened on Star Trek.
Captain Picard would never cheat.
Hello! Without Captain Kirk, there would be no Picard.
Yeah, but Captain Janeway...
Shut up!
Yo, Dexter, I heard you in the shower. Looking for SATs?
Yes, but they have to be actual old tests, not practice ones.
No problem. But when you crack that code, I want it. I need high SATs so I can get into a good college where I can play hoops at.
I guarantee you a perfect score. All you'll have to do is spell your name right.
Uh-oh.
And I'll tutor you on that.
Deal. Now hang on to your diapers, baby. We're going in.
What are you doing? You set off the alarm! You vandalized school property!
Well, those things happen when you steal. Now would be the part when you run. Hi. I'm here for my massage.
Posey, customer!
Oh, my first client. How exciting. This way, please. How do you like it?
Very nice.
Good. Just take off all your clothes and get under the sheet.
What's the hole for?
Your face?
Sweet.
Lady, that massage was a complete ripoff. I was expecting to have sex.
I don't have sex with my customers.
Exactly. Your ad is misleading, Missy.
Misleading? Could you please explain how this ad is misleading? Let Posey's soft hands give you healing relief.
That says release.
Oh my.
Ta-da! 200 vintage SAT tests. Now, all we need to do is complete a few tests, feed them into the computer, and search for a pattern.
I see a pattern. Loser, loser, loser. You guys are wasting your prime years on this crap. When I was your age, I was out drinking and chasing girls instead of worrying about the stupid SAT. And look how I turned out.
Okay, the moment of truth. We need more memory, guys. Go get your computers so we can hotwire them all together.
But are you sure they'll be compatible?
Yeah, your motherboard's pretty old.
Don't you be talking about my motherboard!
Maybe we should give up and start studying.
No, no, just wait!
980? My dad could get that.
It's homing in on the pattern. It just needs more data. Need I remind you of what awaits us should we succeed? God's most perfect creation, the Ivy League. Where brains triumph over brawn, where the term nerd is a compliment, and where nerds from all over the world convene in peace and harmony to share ideas and play computer games. And this is what we are working for. Ergo, no one leaves this room until we crack the code.
Can I at least go to the bathroom?
Sure, if you want to go to Arizona State or Pomona.
I'll just pee in a bottle.
And before you take the SATs, remember, your pencil isn't the only number two you should worry about. From Modium AD, I'm Panzer, your student network EJ. Now here's your local principal.
Good morning, students. It pains me to report that the school administrative offices have been burglarized. A file cabinet was broken, and several years' worth of SAT tests were stolen.
You stole those tests!
You stealer? You made us your unwitting co-stealers!
Hey, relax! I didn't steal anything, okay?
Yo, Dexter, we made the morning announcements. How's that code coming? Dexter, where you going?
Him? You're in this with a jock?
It figures anybody who likes Captain Kirk has to be a jock lover. Captain Janeway would never...
Would you hype her down? The test is Saturday and we're this close to cracking the code.
No, Kevin, you're that close. Goodbye.
I don't need you anyway.
What? Who are you guys? Ron, what are you doing here?
I'm here for a massage. Bring me a drink.
I live here.
Must be nice.
Say it!
Okay, listen up. There is nothing sexual about these massages. If anyone's here for sex, this is not that kind of establishment.
Thank you.
Aww. Andy, how can you live here?
What?
Hello, miss. I'm here about your ad.
No more customers today. I am sorry. Goodbye.
You're working my territory, baby.
No way. You're a pimp, right? A good old-fashioned bell-bottom and platform shoe pimp. Didn't I see you on Beretta?
A pimp is an outmoded term, but yes, I'm here for my cut.
Out! Get out of my home, you cartoonish villain!
I will be back, and you better have my money.
Okay, that's 4 years worth of data. Here we go. Well, I guess you'll just need more data then. A plane leaves Denver at 6:05 p.m., flying at 420 miles per hour. Flora is 16 years old. Florinda is one quarter as old as Flora. Unscrupulous is to unanimous as repudiation. Bling is to blong as blingity bling is to blingity blang. No blong! No bling!
Hey, Kev, you want some spaghetti?
Andy offers Kevin spaghetti at 9. If Kevin is 7 years older than Pudding, how many liters of Andy does it take to get to Denver?
There's, Parmesan cheese in the refrigerator.
Jim Hawkins.
We are so out of here!
Ben.
I've lost my mind.
And
what is that thing?
Ish, a morgue.
On November 27th.
Go, Delbert! Go, Delbert!
Brace yourself.
Three unlikely heroes are taking on the meanest cyborg in the universe.
Pirates on my ship.
Oh, Mama.
Get Mom!
Walt Disney Pictures presents Treasure Planet. Woo! Rated PG.
Get ready for a hug, big guy, because I got a hug.
Coming November 27th.
Yo, kids, here's a flamin' on Cheeto Snacks. Go, go, go. Whoa, Chief, there's no fire here. Just flamin' hot Cheetos. Here, try one. If you can handle it. Flamin' hot Cheetos. Deliciously hot, dangerously cheesy.
And I was this close to cracking the code.
Why don't you just forget the stupid code and study for the damn thing?
What do you want to go to college for anyway, kid? Join the Navy. 3 squares a day and all the gay sex you can handle.
Kevin doesn't want to hear about your Navy days, Gus.
Yeah, I know. I just hate to see him go off his trolley like that other guy.
What other guy?
Well, years back, there was this character who'd sit at the counter all night scribbling on napkins and muttering about this code.
Yeah, till he wigged out. Then, all he could do was babble about the train from Baltimore and the quadratic formula.
Do you know where he lives?
Kevin, come on, give it up.
Where does he live?
That old tenement building on Proctor Street, I think. But that was some time ago.
Wing blong, wing blong. Bling blong, bling blong, bling blong. Bingo! Let's see, pencil. Yes, number 2 pencil!
Go away.
Mr. Pencil, I'm here about the code.
All right. Do not open until you are told to do so.
Sir, may I come in?
Zing zang. You know, every year another sucker comes knocking. Mister, I want to crack the code. It is impossible, I tell you. Impenetrable. God will not be mocked.
I got as high as double 650s.
Hey, you mocked God. Please come in. Yale, huh? I want to go to Cornell just like my dad. You'd think 1320 would be enough for a legacy, but no, zingity zangity, they want extracurriculars. So I started looking for the code. That was 74, 6 long years ago.
That was 26 years ago.
Oh. Well, at least I haven't wasted my entire life.
Well, perhaps if we put our data together, we could actually crack the code.
All right. We may begin.
Eureka! We did it! Mr. Pencil, wake up! Are you ready to go to Cornell? Yep, you're ready for Cornell. Oh my God, the test starts in half an hour!
Yeah, keep banging. That'll make me come faster.
Good morning. You got something for me?
Sure. How's this?
Not so smart, are you, Mr. Pimp Man? Didn't they teach you anything at the Pimp Academy? Look at me, I'm Pimpy McPimpenheimer. Hello, Mr. Pimp, sir. Where are you?
Right here, baby.
Posey, help! Give him some money!
It's not about money now.
No! I'm allergic to being splattered on the pavement. Please! My doctor says I should stay away from head trauma.
No! Please don't!
My back! It's all froze up! I can't feel nothing!
Bad back, huh? Looks like somebody's ready for the old pimp's home.
Would you please help me, bitch?
Okay. Where does it hurt?
Posey, no! What are you doing?
A little lower. Oh, yes, yes. Oh, much better. So that's legitimate massage, huh? Who knew?
What the hell was that about?
I didn't want him to fall off the roof and not feel it.
Oh, come on, stupid. You were supposed to meet me 5 minutes ago. Toby! George! I did it! I cracked the code! It's okay. Take it. Don't you want perfect scores?
My whole life I've waited to be tempted by the forces of evil. I reject you, Kevin!
Yeah, get lost.
Yo, Dexter, you got the code?
Don't do it, Dexter, Kevin.
Top notch. Hey, we make a pretty good team. What school you going to?
Yale. But you wouldn't want to go there. They don't even have a good basketball team.
They do now. Hey, guys, we're going to Yale! Dude, I can't go without my starting lineup. Ooga chaka, ooga chaka.
I was wrong. It was cheating all along. And now I've ruined the whole Ivy League.
Kevin, do something! How much fun is college gonna be if everyone is drinking beer and having sex all the time?
The code must be destroyed!
Yay, Kevin!
Way to go!
Give it!
Never!
Dang.
Hey, no!
Was the most noble swirly I've ever seen.
Well, now I'm screwed. I was so busy trying to cheat, I didn't study. And if I don't show, I'll get a zero.
Too bad they didn't beat you up more. You could have gotten out of the test. On medical grounds.
Hey, that's it. You guys could beat me up. Come on, hit me!
I guess we could rough you up a little.
We can't do this, Kevin. You're our friend.
Did I mention I destroyed your computers?
Haha.
No, really, the motherboards are fried. We're talking total meltdown. Ow, ow, okay, that's fine. Ow, okay, ouch, ow, you guys can stop now. This will not look good on your college application. Ouch!
A Bill Oakley, Josh Weinstein production.
That's what you get for screwing us, Alex. You led us right into the dragon's lair.
Oh, okay, you don't like it? Go back to your mom's basement then.
Whoa! Hey, Alex, when did you get the white trash figures? Looks like you got the whole set.
Nah, he's still missing the Beast of Aquin figure.
I've never even seen one in real life. Only on the back of the box.
Yeah, that's as rare as the Mangled Steve figure in the zombie collection. They only made a few of those because kids were choking on his breakaway guts.
Hello, guys. The dragon. It's gaining. Ye see a tunnel. It's dripping with glowing fungus. Alex, it's your turn.
Okay, so I'll use my Hands of Effluvium spell on that mother.
Hey, kids.
Hi.
What's going on?
It's Rudy.
Oh, Chaka, I thought I warned you about Thursday nights.
Oh, it's dork night. I totally forgot.
Cool dragons. Did you draw these?
No, get your... Ugh, you've exposed a secret map.
Damn, man. There's no way out of this tunnel. It's a dead end. You set us up,
bastard.
Forget it, everyone. I can't play anymore. The campaign is ruined. 2 months down the toilet.
What? Why can't you just make another secret map and play the same pointless game tomorrow night? Such losers.
Listen, if you're trying to shade that I can't map out another entire adventure that fast, you're wrong. Because I could create one by tomorrow, no problem. Oh, wait, except tomorrow, we shall be girding our loins for the Black Mash Horrorcon. Wall-to-wall video games, comics, and toys. Oh, yeah.
Alex, don't tell me you're gonna spend your whole weekend at that geek fest again.
It's not a geek fest, okay? It's about kinship, valor, and the appreciation of the horror sci-fi fantasy culture.
Plus, there's a whole wing on the 7th floor where all the hot goth chicks get all sexed up and have drug-induced orgies.
And you've seen this.
No.
They don't let us up there.
Actually, guys, I've been meaning to tell you. I don't think I'm going to the con.
What? What's wrong with you?
Don't tell me you have a date. What, did you finally ask Serena out?
No.
Oh, so you're just gonna watch her from a safe distance like usual.
Wait, I think I know what's going on here. Is this the weekend of the Battlestar Galactica Marathon?
No, that's next week. It's not about Serena, okay? Something happened to me the other day. I was out looking for the Beast, right? And there in the action figure aisle was this 40-year-old freak guy.
You got no guys. You got all of the ships, but you ain't got none of the guys to drive them. Who's gonna drive the ships?
Man, that's awful. If you're gonna stock the ships, you should have to have the guys.
No, don't you understand? It was a warning. If I don't stop living the life of toy buying, comic book reading, video game playing freak, that'll be me someday. Fat, bald, smelly, and out of my mind, screaming at some teenage stock boy, "You got none of the guys!"
Don't worry, Alex. There'll be plenty of guys left at the con. You could even get the Beast there, probably.
Look, I've got to give up this whole hoarding thing. I want a normal life in the real world with, you know, relationships and girls and stuff.
Alex, as your dungeon master, there's something I should tell you. There are two kinds of people in this world. Those who think the real world is nice, like a postcard from Arizona, and those who know it's a deep, dark, sucking void that no one should ever make a postcard out of.
I thought the two kinds of people were the guys who take their figures out of the box and the guys who don't.
No, no, no. It's the ones who have careers and the ones like us who have day jobs.
Sorry, you're all wrong. It's those that have had sex and those that never will.
Oh, I swear to God, Serena, next time I get Auntie Christ in the wrestling pit, I will have my revenge. Oh.
Francis, go home. We'll find someone to cover for you at the convention.
No, I refuse to let my wrestling career get in the way of my job. Besides, I might be able to complete my Micronauts collection.
I can't believe you want to work at this thing. I'm dreading the whole event. Nothing but a bunch of 30-year-old virgins that only use their opposable thumbs for video games and pulling it.
Trust me, I'm not looking forward to it either. But I figure I've already had the worst job in the world, so what could be so bad?
Yeah? What were you, a dominatrix or something?
No! Matt! No, one summer I was the dunk tank girl at Pippi's, this kiddie amusement park.
Pippi.
I think the reason I attracted so much business is because I grew up in the neighborhood. Everyone hated me.
Really?
Yeah, I was so different from them. I'd yell like, "Hey Vinny in the pink shirt, you throw like a freaking girl." I had water up my nose constantly.
Howdy doody, everyone. Hey B, we suddenly have an opening for another fella to work the con. How about it?
No, I can do it. No. Okay. So you're right.
So what do you say?
No way. Those things scare me, man. All kinds of freaks running around thinking they're Spider-Man and crap. No thanks.
Come on, man. He's a Benjamin.
I'm in.
We must get the Beast. We must be made complete.
No. No more. It's time for me to move on.
You can't stop with an unfinished collection. You will have regrets.
I already have regrets.
Yeah, but you'll have regrets and more action figures.
Look, it doesn't matter. I said I wasn't going, and I can't go crawling back now.
Crawl, Alex, crawl. Come on. You know you want it. Just give in, it's easy.
No! I'm not listening to you anymore, and I'm not going. Hey, do you have a Beast of Akron?
Don't have one, but I saw one being moved in this morning over by aisle 5.
Aw, look, you're right on time, man. Hour late. Fruity time, right?
I'm sorry, B, but I ran into some females, and you know.
Fruity! Finally, I get to take my break.
Hey, I thought that your boyfriend Zeke was supposed to stop by and hang out with you today.
Yeah, as usual, he's dropping the ball. I'm not waiting. Have fun!
Alright, man, check this. This is the deal, alright? Prices are on the back. And whatever you do, do not go letting a guy take a comic out of the Mylar. Alright? Hey, Fruity, come on, man. Where's your head at?
I thought we'd be next to, you know, some of them vampire girls in lace and all. But look at this. We're next to some Rob Zombie wannabe.
Then look in the other direction instead.
The Beast.
Come to me, my child.
Hey, Alex.
Serena?
I was wondering, will you be my boyfriend?
If somebody told you I was just your average, ordinary guy, not a care in the world, somebody lied.
He saved my life twice, and I've never even seen his face.
This is my gift. It is my curse.
Spider-Man, rated PG-13, now playing in theaters.
In theaters this Friday, experience the motion picture phenomenon that has won the Academy Award for Best Animated Feature. Walt Disney Studios presents a Studio Ghibli film from master filmmaker Hayao Miyazaki. Critics have hailed Spirited Away, an animation triumph. Imaginative, mesmerizing, and hypnotic. It's the film Roger Ebert proclaims a masterpiece. Two thumbs up for Miyazaki's Spirited Away, rated PG, in theaters this Friday.
Yes.
I mean, not boyfriend for real.
Oh.
Just like walk around with me, because this clan of dorks, well, they're following me around and leering, not talking to me or anything. But leering is worse than talking anyway.
I always thought talking was much worse. I mean, more damage, you know, limitless possibilities for blurting out something idiotic.
Uh-huh.
Okay then, I'll shut up now.
So is it okay?
Yeah, of course, I mean, yeah, but will you make one quick stop with me?
Absolutely. Thank God I ran into a friend to keep me away from those sorts of guys. They spend all their time with dolls, too afraid of actual people. Don't you think that's pathetic?
Yeah, pathetic.
What about that errand?
Oh, never mind.
Issue 22? Is this the one where the woman I love, Lana Wagner, first finds out about her symbiote?
Yeah. It's all about that crap. And there's some other stuff like that in there. Hey, girls, come over here. Help me sell some comics, huh?
Is it really Mint, or is it just excellent stretching for Mint?
Hey, girls, don't you know he's not a real athlete? He's just a wrestler.
Easy, little man.
Look, just tell me how much this thing is, okay?
$1.95, man. Jeez, don't get all agitated. Hey, understudy, did you have to go to, like, embalming school and crap?
Ooh.
Ooh, he got you good, bro. Come on, Fruity. We got customers, man. Let's just get back to it, all right?
Yeah, look what I did. I made you a sale from that Andrew sex book. It was $1.95, but look, he left the whole two.
What? That comic was worth $195, not $1.95.
Damn, man.
So you're saying I messed up?
Yeah, and I could get fired for something like this?
Don't worry about it.
Hey, it's all good. I'll just go fix it like I always do.
And the second I make manager, I'm quitting.
No way. That's exactly what I promised myself, too.
I think this aisle only sells things made by underpaid children in China. So we should really get off it.
That wasn't Alex right there, was it?
Nah, that guy was with a girl.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize what this was. I'm sorry. I really didn't mean to. I swear.
Alex, look. Sexy robot books. Cool.
It's nice.
Nice? It's completely hot. I love these books. There are all these great half-naked female robot figures. And you know, even though I'm a girl, I still think breasts are totally erotic.
Oh, wow. I like the way all the features are so well rendered.
God, you know, those guys that were leering at me probably couldn't even handle this much intimacy with a girl.
We have to find out if that was Alex. We have to, damn. She got it on.
I feel weird.
Here, stop by and check out the assy table. I'm in the new issue.
I totally remember the first time I discovered porn, don't you?
Yeah. It was a little, unsettling.
Really?
I was going through my dad's closet in hopes of finding some foreign coins I could take to the bank in exchange. And these tapes are sticking out from under swimming trunks. I mean, I don't want to look, but I do. I can't help myself. So I pull it out, and it's porn.
Whoa.
My normal clean-cut dad had Debbie Does Dallas and Star Whores.
Those are total classics. So what? What did you do? Did you watch them?
No. No, I did not.
Yeah, right. After the first porno I saw, I snuck into my mother's bathroom, tried on her G-string underwear, and pranced around in front of the mirror, trying to see if I could turn myself on. It was so silly.
Would you excuse me? I have to go to the bathroom.
Okay. I don't have to go, but I'll walk there with you.
Hey, buddy. $50 for the book.
Hey, man. Oh, sorry. Damn. It's like a uniform.
Oh, God.
Look, it's exactly the opposite every place else in the world.
You sure you don't have to go?
No, I'm good. It looks like it's your turn, though. I'll wait here.
Damn that run to an ale. Alex, are you?
Goat. Look, don't tell anyone I was here, okay?
Whatever you say, boss. You all right, man?
No. Goat, will you do me a favor and buy something for me? I can't do it because I'm with this girl and I don't want her to think I'm a toy-hoarding loser. It's the Beast of Akron.
I know where you're coming from, baby. Because a woman once held me back from my dream in life.
The Jousting World Championships. But she wouldn't lend me the money for a plane ticket. My mom's cheap.
So the Beast of Akron, huh?
Yeah. I don't know how much it's going to be, so here's my credit card. But be careful with it. The interest rate is a mother.
Rock on!
Hey.
Hey. So, what do you want to do now?
I don't know. I have to make an appearance upstairs. Want to go up to the 7th floor?
Really? The 7th floor? Okay, then.
Well, I don't know. Since you're in your dorky work clothes still, you probably need this. Try this. No, that's not right yet. Nah, forget it. Let's just go.
San Andreas, out now on PlayStation 2. Rated M for mature.
Rated M for mature. Forget everything you think you know about Resident Evil. Resident Evil 4.
Hello.
Thank you. Hi.
Hey, Serena.
How's it going?
Hi.
Well, it seems like you know everyone.
Yeah, but I really don't dig a lot of the stuff they're about. Serena, hey. I mean, there are some people up here who actually believe they're vampires.
Serena.
Hey, Serena. I left you a message a while back, but you never called.
Yeah, my voicemail's been screwy. See ya. I used to go out with that ass. He kept trying to get me in a three-way with his ex. God, I really don't want to run into any more surprises. Can we go hang out somewhere quiet until my break's over?
Yeah, sure.
Excuse me, guy. Sorry about that. Pardon me. Hey, you, wait up, man.
Hey, there's been a mistake.
Shh.
You know, with that Android cup, it's 195. But the upside is there's no sense.
Sucks for you.
Okay, if you're gonna be that way, just give me the comic back.
I'm sorry. That number cannot be completed as dialed.
I said, give me the comic.
Do you have a problem with our friend?
Yo, man, or whatever. Did you know that somebody put makeup and girls' clothes all over you? Weirdo. Hey, there's no need to be doing nothing rash.
Let go! You're gonna rip it!
Aha! I got it!
Careful! Please
don't! Come any closer, and this becomes a double issue. I dare you, Cupcake.
He's serious! That's an Andro Synth 22!
No.
And it's mint!
I see.
Hey, Trap! You seen Serena?
A while ago. She was walking around with some guy.
She was with a guy?
Pretty sure he was a guy, yeah.
Someone is gonna get hurt.
Ashy?
You can sit down. You know, I'm glad Zeke's not here yet. And I get to hang out with you and just talk. Do you ever notice how easy it is to talk to someone that you're not sleeping with?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I mean, I'm so sick of being with these screwed up guys all the time.
Really?
I have such crummy luck. Or taste. What is it with girls like me? All a guy has to say is that he's been in prison or rehab, and it's like my head tips right over and my brain starts to slip out of my ear.
So which choice is Zeke?
Both.
You know, if you wanted to, I'm sure you could have a different great guy to go out with every night. And twice some nights.
No way. I've always been a mess. In high school, I had to ask a boy to kiss me, and he said no. Well, needless to say, I didn't kiss him. In fact, I scraped the bottom of the barrel that night.
So why didn't you kiss the guy you wanted?
He acted all weird, like he wasn't interested. But later I found out he liked me, but the way I dressed put him off. What about you? What was your first kiss like?
Well, this girl that liked me just grabbed me and kissed me.
I dare you to kiss Alex.
No way, he's a freak.
Wimp.
Okay, fine. But I'm not using tongue.
Wow, you're so lucky.
Yeah, lucky.
Maybe I'd be luckier if I tried dating someone nice for a change.
Nice guys. Where all their reliability and consideration, half the prison record.
Yeah?
Sure.
Serena! I know you're in there!
It's Zeke!
Open up!
I'd better let him in.
What's this about you being with some other guy?
Hey, man. I don't think that Serena wants to go.
And to think, Trap had me all worked up over nothing. Come on, let's go.
Go! Go, wait! Hey, man. Did you get the Beast of Akron?
Yes, somewhere in here. By the way, I got a few other things with your card. I'll pay you back. Check this out, man. Underage midget porn. They're small and misproportioned, yet sexy.
Goat, what about the Beast?
Yeah, I got it. Wait, here it is. The Beats of Akron.
What the hell, man? You don't throw these things.
Hey, don't ruin my glory moment, B. That's good, John.
Robot foot!
Oh.
freaks rest in peace. I know we had our words, but man, I hate those guys. Adults dressing up in weirdo costumes.
Hey man, thanks. That was unbelievable. I am truly afraid of you now. I guess I was wrong.
And don't you forget it.
Hey, can I get a picture?
You want a picture? You got it.
Come on, guys. Time to crawl back through whatever bridge or tunnel you came from.
S.C.
Go on, guys. Come on now. Shoo, shoo. Go home to your mothers. Let's go.
Hey, I saw it first.
Piss off!
Hey, it is Alex.
Go, man, go.
Stay on target.
I really need this.
Need? What do you know about need? You're just a little kid. Need is when you're old and have high cholesterol and you're afraid of public transportation and you never needed a hotel room with a double bed. Ever. And you go to a store and they got none of the guys.
Take it, man.
Oh, no.
You need it a lot more than I do.
Oh, what do you mean? No.
Hey, Serena, come back here!
So, what's wrong with you?
I dumped Zeke. He was a loser.
And you're sad?
Uh-huh.
But you dumped him.
Yeah, so?
At least you didn't miss meeting the Undertaker this weekend, Matt. He was sitting the next table over.
Yep. I told you how he saved Fruity's ass by pulverizing 10 guys at once, right?
These aren't gonna make us feel any better.
Yeah. Here, give me the mystery flavor.
No, Dad, you don't understand. That's not it at all. I actually enjoy playing bingo. I don't want to schedule bingo. I don't want to see the word bingo in my date book on Saturday. Saturday night, bingo. You know what I'm saying? Not yet. Ben?
Yeah?
Don't get Fruit Loops on my bed, please.
Sorry.
I would like you to do me a favor. Bring Grandpa to the urologist today. Would you do that for me?
To the what?
To the urologist.
The urologist?
The urologist. Would you do that for me?
Come on, Dad. You can't just spring this kind of thing on me at the last minute. You know, I have a life, and I've got things to do today.
Well, Ben, that's why they invented the VCR.
Oh, that's very funny.
Now, what do you have to do today?
Well, I have to return some calls.
Mm-hmm.
I have to get my resume into ship shape.
Hey, you can take my car.
I have to bring Grandpa to the urologist.
Thanks, Ben. I appreciate it, believe me.
I don't have to go in there with him, do I?
No, but remind him to put his pants back on.
Right, because last time. Is there a problem?
They have to do a cleaning process. Let me explain to you what's involved. They put a tube in.
Yeah, but...
I don't remember. Did I show you the latest picture of my twins?
Yeah. You tried.
Oh, right, yeah. I forgot. You're not into kids. Sorry.
It's okay. Dr. Katz's office? Yes, he is. It's your wife.
Wife. Can I take this one here?
Mm.
Hi, honey. Yeah? All right, go ahead. 4 cans chunky in spring water. Large box honey nut Cheerios.
Two push dozen.
Hold
two,
on.
Right
hold
there,
on a second.
Number 2, right there.
Dr. Katz's office. No, this isn't the doctor. I'm a patient. You too? Yeah, that's nice. Uh-huh. Yeah, well, it sounds like you're doing great, yeah. Do you want to leave a message or something? Or can you hold on a second? Sorry, honey. Okay. Variety pack of cereal. Uh-huh. Maple syrup. I'm sorry. Look, I thought there was a whole other thing in the thing there. All right. No, you're right. I didn't check. Look, I'm sorry. Dozen crayon apple juice boxes. Hold on. Dr. Katz's office. No, I didn't abandon you. I didn't. I put you on hold for a second. Take it easy. Look, pal, I'm sorry if I hurt you, all right?
Mr. Romano.
Hello?
Mr. Romano, the doctor will see you now.
Thank God. My 3-year-old. I'll tell you what, that's the age to be, though, Doc.
Sure. That's a wonderful age.
I always thought if I could go back in time, I'd want to be a teenager, but you don't get happier than 3. I watch my daughter. It's incredible. The other day, she's staring out the car window for 15 minutes with a smile on her face. Just smile, nonstop smile. I couldn't get over. Finally, I just turned to her. I say, Alexandra, what are you thinking of? Candy. When's the last time you could daydream about candy? You ever have that nice a day? When you have a free moment, can you fill it with candy? No, you can't because you're an adult. There's too many other things now. Oh, who am I? Why am I here? Am I gay? What's that lump? There's no room for candy.
Well, you're an adult now, Ray. You have responsibilities, you know. You have lumps, I assume. You want one of those?
I have to go to Canada next week to work. Have you been to Montreal, Doc?
Yeah.
Yeah. The French people, they kind of annoy me. Not that they're annoying, they just won't speak English to you.
Right.
They're all bilingual and they have an attitude with the English. You know what amazed me is I went into a Burger King in Montreal. The Burger King employees are required to be bilingual. Just think about that, Doc. I don't know if you've been to Burger King here in our country. They're not even lingual over here. You have to draw your food. I want a hamburger. 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 I don't want a pie. Put the pie down. I see the pie. I want a hamburger to go. I'm going to go. Here, I'll draw little feet on my hamburger. See? It's self-explanatory.
You know what I think your problem is, Jonathan? You spend too much time with unhappy people. It's starting to rub off.
So you think I should just treat the cheerful?
No, you know what I'm saying.
That would be, Julie, like me telling you that you're spending too much time with thirsty types.
No, listen.
That's just the way it works. That's what I do. I see people who are unhappy. That's how I make my living.
Can somebody see you even if they're not, like, depressed?
Borderline.
They might need to, yeah.
That happens all the time. People come in. People aren't always depressed when they arrive.
Like they might need to talk about a particular problem that they're having?
Yeah, there are people who come in with a specific problem. I think I'm overqualified in a certain way to treat those people. I think very often what they need is like a smart aunt.
A friend of mine told me something, and I think she would really, it would help her a lot if she had somebody to talk to, but...
Well, you know what, let me give you my number at work, and maybe she can call me, you know, and if she wants to talk about it.
Well, that's a good idea.
Okay, here, it's on the back of my card.
This is nice.
Just tell her...
This is a cute card.
Tell her to mention when she calls that she's a friend of yours.
Who's this little person on here?
What do you mean, the cartoon?
Yeah.
That's supposed to be me.
Yeah.
You don't think it doesn't look like me?
Well, what's in your hand?
That's a pencil in my hand.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think it was?
I don't know. It's just sort of... It looks like a pencil. It looks like a pencil.
I'm feeling very feminine right now, Dr. Katz, because I got my period today. And most of my friends got it when they were 13, so I guess I'm a little immature.
This germ phobia of yours, where do you think that comes from?
My mother. She's so neurotic. She puts down toilet paper on the seat, even at our relative's house, at the dinner table. And if that's not crazy, I don't know where else I got it from.
No, that's crazy.
New locations, new characters, new interactions. Brace yourself. The Sims are on vacation. Rated T for teen.
When it seems like all is lost. When it feels as if you have no hope. When you are outnumbered, overpowered, and they've got you cornered. That's when you realize your last best hope is you. Halo, Combat Evolved, rated M for mature.
Hey, are you going up?
Yeah, I thought I would, since we're on the ground floor.
Oh, right, right.
Aren't you getting out?
No, I'll stay in. I'll ride up with you. How about that? I'm in no hurry. I got really nothing planned. Hey, you remember me, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, I'm Ben Katz.
I remembered.
Right, Dr. Katz's son, Ben Katz.
Yes, I said I remembered.
That's who I am. You look well. You look good. Unless you have a peachy look to you.
Peachy?
Yeah, you got a good shimmer off your skin, like a shine. You're all shiny.
I went to the zoo the other day.
That's
and
fun.
I love the monkeys. Aren't they so cute? Oh. And the little giraffes, they're so cute. And my least favorite are the, the little heads, the kids.
Ah.
Those, they're always screaming and crapping.
Mm.
Kids are cute if they belong to your sister and you can leave. But sometimes I take her to Disneyland and I don't like it there at all because I don't like mice.
Okay. This is some elevator, huh?
This is the slowest elevator I've ever ridden on.
Yeah, don't you find though that the
are we stopped?
Hey, just think, someday this elevator will be mine. I'll own it.
Wow.
I'll rent it. I won't own it. I'll lease it with an option to buy it. It'll be my elevator, sort of. Hey, have you had lunch?
No.
Neither have I. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Why is it so hard to not hear you?
Wow. That is not what I was expecting to hear. So you don't, you wouldn't want to have lunch then? Is that what you're saying? I mean, because
I'm in my own private hell.
Am I echoing to you?
I am in my own private hell. You're not here.
Oh. You know, I get the feeling we're not connecting.
I hate dating. Mm-hmm. I am never myself on a date. Mm-hmm. I never eat as much as I want, and I have to speak in that British accent. Maybe I'm old-fashioned, Dr. Katz, but I like it when a man pays for sex.
Oh.
But I've been getting much more spiritual lately. I read the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
That guy can write. No, Mrs. Liebman. And even if the doctor knew what Wendy wanted for her birthday, he wouldn't be able to tell you. It's called patient confidentiality. Well, it's the law. I'm sorry. All right, bye-bye. Dr. Katz's office. I'm still fine, Mrs. Liebman. Mrs. Liebman, I told you. The doctor does not sell gift certificates.
I don't know what's wrong with me, Stan. I seem to be stuck in this middle-aged, this is my life, get used to it rut. And I don't like it. I don't like the way it sounds.
Yeah. Look, Katz, listen.
Yeah.
We both know what you need.
Which is?
Which is a little,
Oh, you're talking about some
No. I mean some serious
zavouv.
Hey, but look, even if I wanted some zavouv, where would I find any? You know what I'm saying? In my life?
I don't know.
Think
don't
about
know.
It.
I don't know, but you must meet a lot of desperate women, right?
Stanley, you know I'm not allowed to fool around with my patients. You know, I took an oath.
An oath?
Not an oath. I took an oath.
An oath?
Oath.
See, that was your big mistake. You should never take an oath.
Well, it doesn't seem to be a problem for you.
Of course not. I mean, women just, you know, they just, they gravitate towards me. I mean, I don't understand. I think I have a certain kind of magnetism.
So you think my problem with women might just be electrical?
Yes, that's possible. I mean, I've done what I can. I mean, I've, remember last year I invited you to the office party?
Please.
And, yeah, like 10-15 women that you could have chosen from?
Yeah, but Stanley, if you introduce me to them as the loneliest guy in the universe...
I'm trying to help you. Trying to help you.
Give me some advice, like something I can use, you know. Even a line, you know, that thing you gave me last year, do I seem feverish? Works.
You know what it is? Shoes. You need to upgrade your shoes.
What are you talking about?
It's the first thing that women look at.
They look at the shoes?
Yeah.
But flats is the right move, isn't it?
Yeah. You don't want to wear heels, but you want something cool. Mm. Women like, in addition to shoes, they like smiles. They feel less threatened by a smile, even though a smile is an act of aggression in and of itself, which I'm sure you know.
Yeah.
But they like, if you smile at them, just a nice, warm smile.
I wish, I don't smile easily, because I'm self-conscious about my teeth.
You know what works? Just a drop of vinegar on the roof of your mouth will give you a nice big smile for about 2-3 seconds.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah.
But won't they see you applying the vinegar?
You turn around and wow, it's a big smile.
What if every choice you made changed the way you look and how people see you? Would you forgo virtue and choose a wicked path? Become the very picture of evil? Decide your destiny. Fable, for every choice, a consequence. Rated M for mature.
Get ready for Adam Sandler.
I'll do it all night long.
He's rude.
Please excuse me while I go take shower.
He's crude.
Oh, shut up!
He's animated.
Oh, my!
He brought you Happy Gilmore. The Water Boy. And Big Daddy. Now, Adam Sandler's entering a whole new world. Adam Sandler's 8 Crazy Nights.
Look, my point is that when I was a kid, we were poor. Mm-hmm. Very poor. But my parents never let on. My mother used to make a dish for dinner.
Dad, you know how many times that you
consisted
told...
of one piece of American cheese, 2 peas for the eyes, a cherry tomato for the nose, and a piece of celery for the mouth. Mm-hmm. Do you know what she called that?
As a matter of fact, I do.
She called it clown, Ben, and we loved it.
Clown.
We looked forward to it.
Mm-hmm. Dad?
Yes. Yes. I'm sorry. What?
Can I ask you a question quickly?
Yes.
Why do these pep talks always have to be so depressing?
I don't know. I guess it's my training.
Your training.
Well, this is what I'm hearing you say. It seems like you have a hard time maintaining relationships with men.
Well, just my last boyfriend. We were incompatible, to say the least. I mean, I'm a night person, and he didn't like me.
Mm.
And he was married. I don't know if I should mention that. I was married. A long time ago. I was too young when I got married. I got married right after college. It was terribly messy, the divorce. It was so messy because there was a baby involved. Him.
Do you think that you deliberately sabotage your relationships?
I don't know. I just want to meet a sensitive guy. You know, a man who will cry when I hit him. No, I would never hit a man if he were sober. Can you validate my parking stub?
Your what?
Well, the valet guy said you'd validate.
The valet guy? We don't have a valet. This is a laundry ticket.
Well, What are you saying?
I'm saying this is a laundry ticket. I'm saying that you seem to have given someone your car for a laundry ticket.
I don't see the humor in that.
Well, it's very subtle.
Should I talk about my neurosis now?
Nothing would make me happier, Ray.
You're faking it.
No, I mean it. I would like to get into that area. That's what this is all about.
The big thing is I can't watch the game anymore. The holidays.
Yeah.
The holidays are the hardest time for me with sports. I don't like that they put football on Thanksgiving because it just starts fights in my family. The men want to watch the game. The women don't. You know what they do? They compromise the women. They put the TV on without the volume, which never works because then you have to pretend like you're paying attention to your family. Oh, Grandma, could you pass me the gravy, please? Pass it. I'm open. Get rid of it. Pass the gravy. Oh, you suck. So I'm not going to shut up. We should have got rid of her last year. Look at her. She's a loser. I can't watch a game.
Oh, Ray. What am I going to do with you, laddie boy?
Fix me.
Oh, man.
Hey, Dad, will you pass the snack things?
Oh, yeah. The what are they called? Pretzel bits?
Pretzelkins. Pretzelkins.
Who makes these things?
Aren't they good, though? They're filled with the cheesy thing. Hey, Dad.
Yeah?
Are you sticking around here tonight? Are
you... Well, I thought, you know, I rented a movie. I thought maybe we could
Yeah, well, actually, and... I rented a movie, too, so...
Yeah. Well, we can watch them both. You know, why don't... Just sort of get cozy here. Should I get that comforter in the...
No.
Oh, come on, Ben.
Well...
When was the last time you and I just sort of...
We're under a comforter? I don't think cozy is a good
thing. Come here, snuggle up with your dad for 1 minute.
Dad, stop talking like this, because...
Who's your snuggle bunny?
That's...
Huh?
You're making me uncomfortable. I mean, this isn't... This is like... I thought you were maybe... You should go out. You should actually go. You should
what
go.
What are you saying, Ben?
I'm saying I can't see you anymore, Dad, like this. I can't.
What, are you just going to drop it on me like that?
Well, I feel that honesty is the best policy here because...
You met someone else, didn't you?
Well, I met... I was thinking of having a friend over maybe tonight, and I was hoping that, you know, I rented
a
couple of movies, and,
they're
probably movies that you wouldn't like, and so I was thinking that...
No, that's all right. I have a little work to do anyway.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't mean to be... You know, I mean, this is your
house. Don't worry about it. No, Ben, you do what you... You and your friends watch movies and enjoy.
Well, thanks. You know, I just feel bad because you seem to... I think that you spend a lot of time here with me.
Mm-hmm.
And that you should maybe go meet some people your age. Go out
and
have fun.
Okay, let me see. Does this mean that we're not going dancing tomorrow?
You know what frightens me now, actually, Doc, is I'm forgetting things. Forgetting things that aren't normal.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot my own phone number. I forgot. I was trying to tell this guy my number, and all I could remember was the first three numbers. And then you try to give your brain a running start. You know, like, hold on a second. 457. Ah! Yeah. Mm. I could see the 4, the 5, and the 7, and then the rest of the numbers were, like, taunting me and a ring around the rosy and... And other numbers went flashing by on my old high school gym locker.
Mm-hmm.
I had this memory lapsed. This one really scared me. You're in your shower, and you're daydreaming. I'm daydreaming. Mm-hmm. And then I can't remember if I shampooed my hair. I had to backtrack in my own shower. What did I do? Well, let's see. I got in the shower. I sang Piano Man. I always sing Piano Man. And then what? You know what I do now, Doc, is I actually bring a checklist into my shower. I just check it off as I go along. All right, I did that. All right, I'll do that next. All right, not going to have time for that. I don't think I have enough soap. I think you know what I'm talking about, don't you? Every man knows what happens in a shower.
Oh.
Not ashamed of it. We were given the gift and we use it. And I know why we do that more than women. It's obvious. I think God gave man the ability to create these fantasies. It's not our fault. It's entrapment from God. I know women can fantasize, but, oh, they have no idea what men are capable of. We have a cast of thousands in there. It's too many. There's people in there you don't even want half the time. Mom, security, my mother got in. Who let my mother in? Who let my fat mother here? Oh, that sends me right to therapy when my mother makes a cameo.
Ray, you let her in. It's your fantasy.
It's my mother's fault. She's,
Whoops, you know what the music means. Our time is up.
I-10. G-13. G-13.
If you can help, please give as much as you can to the
desperate savage murderers who would gouge out your eyes and cut off your tongue for satanic rituals on the next Geraldo.
What's that address again? These guys jam.
Camera! Silence on the set! Tape rolling! 3, 2, 1, action! Welcome to the Church of Suicidal! We're now summoning a wonderful recital! But before we go on, there's something I must mention! A important message I must bring to your attention! I was in meditation and prayer last night! I was awoken by a shining bright light. Overhead, a glorious spirit. He gave you a message and you all need to hear it. Look what he said. He said,
"Send me over
now." Now how much you give? It's your own choice. But to me, it's the difference between a Porsche and a Rolls Royce. I want you to make it hurt when you dig into your pocket. Cause it makes me feel so good to watch the profit track it. Not digging deep, dig real deep.
Kick ass.
I want you to make it hurt.
Kick ass.
What's he dead? What's he dead at cost? What's he doing? What's he your mama's dead? Cause they got gold in a row. Who's gonna be the new king of the fakers? Who's gonna take a place for Jim and Tammy Faye Baker? See, my mama, she didn't raise no fool. Cause you can't put a price on a merit pool. Amen.
That's pretty cool.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. Other brothers can't deny. Yeah, when a girl walks in with an itty-bitty waist and around
things, he's standing
face,
on a butt.
Sprung.
Yeah.
Wanna pull up something, you notice that butt was stuck. Deep in the jeans she's wearing. I'm hooked and I can't stop staring. Oh, baby, I wanna get whipped up and take your picture. My homeboy tried to warn me.
I like butts. Butts are cool.
Yeah, I'm getting a stiffy.
Use me, cause you ain't that average groupie.
Butt cheeks.
36, 24, 36. Only if she's 5'3". So your girlfriend rolls a Honda. Playing workout tapes by Fonda. But Fonda ain't
got a motor in the back of her Honda. My anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun. Give me a sip.
Look at all those buns.
Red beans and rice didn't miss her. Some knucklehead tried to diss, cause his girls are on my list. He had game, but he chose to hit him. And I pull up quick to get with him. So ladies, if the butt is round and you want a triple X throwdown, mix a lot and kick them nasty thoughts. Baby got back.
I'm pitching a tent.
Baby got back. Little in the middle, but you got much back.
Whoa.
Little in the middle, but you got much back.
This is the 90s, people. A 9 upside down is a 6. So let's turn the 90s upside down and recapture the spirit of the 60s, okay?
Watch those flashbacks, dude.
Excuse me. Could I have your attention, please? Okay, this week we're going to learn a little bit about that spirit by giving of ourselves. We're all going door to door to collect for the consumer goods for overseas children's
no
fund.
No way.
Of course, I can't force you to work for charity thanks to our Constitution's delicate balance between individual liberties and the common good. Nor would I want to because of my own beliefs in personal freedom. So anyone who doesn't want to collect can complete the 60s project by doing a book report on the electric Kool-Aid acid test.
Oral.
Written or oral.
Yeah.
Cool. But first, of course, you've got to read the book.
That guy's touching his wiener.
Yeah. I'm gonna touch my wiener.
If you're like famous, you can touch your wiener and nobody cares. Isn't that dude on 92010?
Yeah. That show sucks.
Yeah. Those chicks are stuck up.
Yeah. Stuck up my butt.
You think he knows that everybody hates him?
Yeah.
What a wuss. This video would be cool if they had, like, chicks and tight pants everywhere.
Yeah. And lots of fire and explosions.
Yeah. And car accidents. Then it would be cool. This video is stupid. Change it.
What a dork.
What do you learn in school? School's a fool.
He's talking about school.
School's a fool. Your teacher tells you what to say.
Hey, Beavis, do you know how to read? That guy's a dumbass.
School sucks.
Yeah.
Yes?
Got any money? We're collecting for the poor.
Great, I just lost my job.
What in the hell? What do you want?
We're collecting for the poor. Help them buy meals and stuff.
Meals? There's one.
The 60s must have sucked.
Maybe at this house it'll be a beautiful chick.
Hello? Collecting for charity.
Help the poor.
Come in, boys. I've been waiting for you. Now, turn on the lamp.
Once again, boys, who do you serve?
You, Mrs. Cora.
Whose wrath do you fear?
Yours, Mistress Cora. Yeah.
Yes, that Madonna book was worth every penny.
Whoa.
Erotica.
Romance.
That was cool.
Yeah.
Erotica.
My name's Dita. I'll be your mistress tonight.
Gotta go, dude. Gotta go spank my monkey.
Bow down before the one you serve.
These guys are cool.
People, I'm proud to announce that we've collected more than $8 for our charity drive.
$8? Sad, dude.
Yeah.
But what makes me especially proud is this note I received from Ms. Cora Anthrax on Willow Place. When your charity work was explained to me by those charming young men, Beavis and Butthead, my heart went out to those poor children overseas. Good luck, and please send Beavis and Butthead around if you need more. And students, it's a check for $100. I'm proud of you guys. And here's your prize for collecting the most money in our Spirit of the 60s drive. A Moby Grape album for each of you. You know, it hurts me to part with these guys. They're collector's items. But giving till it hurts is part of what the 60s were all about.
Nice catch, dude.
Watch this. Behind the back. Damn.
What happened if you stuck a firecracker into that little hole? That would be cool.
The National Hurricane Center in Miami, where Chief Forecaster Gordon Dunn is checking first reports. And Houston Control for the space flight. Scheduled to splash down Sunday, right in the path of the storm.
That guy's a dumbass.
Yeah. He looks like David Letterman.
Trick photography. That's pretty cool. Whoa. Storms are cool. Whoa. That's pretty cool.
Wind is cool.
Here
Later, pony.
That's cool.
Hurricanes are cool. I like when the wind knocks stuff over and it lands on people.
Yeah. And it tears the roof off.
Bounty Hunter the galaxy has ever seen. Star Wars Bounty Hunter, rated T for teen.
Still the best. And 5 out of 5. That's what GamePro said about new Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 4. It's the ultimate challenge, and it's available now. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 4, rated teen.